Morning, you're listening to Aaron. Happy Friday. It's 11:15. Now next, we're going to talk about the fact it's Family History Month. Now, family history and genealogy seems to really gather momentum in the past few years with a number of programs on your telly. Now, Turi King, a name you probably are familiar with after the work with Richard III. Well, Turi is a professor of genetics at the University of Leicester and features in the TV show DNA Family Secrets. She joins us now on BBC Radio Leicester. Morning, Turi.
Good morning.
You're happy and chirpy. That's exactly what we need on a Friday. Now, we're a nation that's kind of obsessed with family history. Why? Where's it come from? Why is it getting so big?
Okay, so I think there's a few things going on here, and we're not the only country. So I have to say US, Canada, Australia, New Zealand, people all over the world are really, really interested in this. And I kind of got in the field about 20 odd years ago when my PhD was looking at kind of surnames and family history. And the number of people who started contacting me, it was just huge, and it has completely snowballed. And I think part of that has to do with the fact that you've got this huge rise in databases that are available now. So you can go and you can look up things like, you know, birth certificates, marriage certificates, and so on. You can build your family tree. All of this stuff is available. And also genetic testing. So it means you can get your DNA tested and you can kind of kickstart your family tree because you can look at people who you're matching and then you can start to kind of swap family trees with them and build a giant family tree. It's just growing like really, like exactly as you say, it's just huge.
It's huge, but I know like one of the issues that I would have if I was to ever try and find out more and more is I know my mum's family, if you go back a couple of generations, actually changed their surname because of what was happening in the country at the time. And then as soon as that changes, you go, well, hold on. If the name's changed, then other things have changed. And then how do you start leading it back? So surely it's like this minefield of things that just pop up and you go, really? And then you start losing track. How do you go about doing it?
So that's where DNA can actually really come into its own. Because even if you have got things like a name change, you can look for people who you share DNA with. There also might be records of things like that name change. And that's one of the really, that's one of the really fascinating things that you get. So particularly people who, you know, well, we're a country of immigrants, but also places like the US, where you've got people going into Ellis Island, and they're changing their names. And you see records of this as they're landing and all this kind of stuff. So it's actually that whole kind of surname change is all part of the really interesting stuff that goes on when you're looking at your family history. I mean, it's so cool, isn't it, to find out about that kind of thing. What was your family going through at that time?
I know you touched upon this a few moments ago because you've worked in genealogy for a while. And I know you said the access to things like DNA and stuff is getting better and better. But how's the access to information changed since you've been involved from how you started, when you started, to what it is now?
Oh, it massively. So people used to have to go to record offices and this kind of thing. These days, there's so much online, so much online. In fact, it's kind of scarily easy how, you know, quickly you can do this kind of thing now, just because the databases are all there. So if you go, for example, to, you know, Ancestry or 23andMe or MyHeritage or Living, any of these kind of big companies, you can start to build your family tree. You get, as soon as you put kind of a name in or a record in, it'll give you a little hint. It'll go, ooh, we think we might have found a record to your ancestor's birth. We think we might have found a marriage record. We think we might have found a relative. So it's the fact that all of this stuff, it's just the way stuff's evolved with everything kind of going online now. It's so much easier to do this.
Which is, yeah, so much easier, but then there's so much more to do, if that makes sense, at the same time, because you just keep going, we can go further. Now,
yeah.
we mentioned that there seems to be more and more TV shows about this at the moment. Now, I often think, now, bear with me a moment, because yesterday we were talking on BBC Radio Leicester about someone who had found a painting by a famous artist and they didn't know it was a famous artist and they watched a TV show and that kind of made them go, well, maybe this is worth something. It turned out it was worth £18,000 rather than the £12 they bought the frame for originally from Carboot. So I asked the question yesterday whether or not there were many all these TV shows about antiques and so forth, do you think it's more about educating people on what may be possible? And the same with this when it comes to TV shows. I don't think, or what do you think, they're just there for entertainment? It's more to kind of catch everyone's intriguement of going, well, hold on, if they're doing that, maybe I can do the same.
Oh, absolutely. So one of the really nice things about DNA family secrets that we do is that we're answering, you know, family mysteries for people. So things like they might not know about their ancestry, or, you know, they're a sperm donor child, they'd like to know something about their ancestry or trace their sperm donor father, or they're adopted, or so on and so forth. And one of the things that has happened to me over the years, but particularly after DNA Family Secrets, after the first series, is I was inundated, absolutely inundated with people going, I didn't know you could do this. Can you help me? How can I find this person, this, and so on and so forth. So it is, in a way, educating people. And I love the fact that you get to slip in information about how DNA inheritance works and how we're related to one another. So I love that I get to kind of slip in all of this genetic information as part of the program. But yeah, absolutely educational, and also helping people. So one of the things that so comes across with DNA Family Secrets, when people come, it's something like, I've been adopted, or I was brought up in foster care, and the thing that you really feel coming across from them is this longing for information. Something's missing from their lives. They feel there's a hole there, and being able to give them information to help them with that. Usually it's something around, you know, it's about identity. It's about who they are. And they're missing this information. So to be able to provide them with information to help kind of fill in those pieces of the puzzle that are missing, I mean, that's what I really, really love about that program.
You said something there that really sparked something in my mind, where you said DNA inheritance. Now, there are potentially different types of people that would want to follow this kind of suit of DNA Family Secrets. And there are some that are just intrigued by what's going on. Are there many that get involved because they go, there's got to be some money in there for me somewhere?
We haven't had any of that so far. I mean, okay, that's not true. I get people who regularly contact me and say that they think that they are descended from royalty and that kind of thing. We're all related to royalty. All of us are. Occasionally, you will get somebody who thinks that they're being denied their birthright. But it's not something that I normally get somebody contacting me saying, I think I'm actually owed money, that kind of thing. Normally, it's a very straightforward, I'm missing this part of my life, and I would like to know more about it.
I like that, especially when you said about royalty, because I'm pretty certain, like, I should be a prince of somewhere or something. So maybe we need to go digging into that to find out whether or not. But wait, what do you mean we're all related to royalty?
Well, okay, so if you think about it, if you go back, you know, you've got two parents, four grandparents, eight great-grandparents. If you go back, you know, even a few hundred years, the number of, you know, putative ancestors you should have is more than the population of the world. We are all interrelated to each other. So you will have royalty in your family tree. Of course you will. You might have to go up the tree sideways and down again, but they will be there.
So I can legitimately start calling myself a king, and I wouldn't be wrong.
Well, so that all comes into like lines of inheritance and how royalty is passed down through the generations. So you can go right ahead, but you might have some issues with actually kind of like the real claim to the throne.
Yeah, but I like that. We'll keep going. Now, Tori, I can only like fathom that when you're having conversations with friends or you're meeting up with people when you're not working, they're always kind of intrigued about things. And people kind of always just chipping away going, could you just find out this for me?
Actually, well, okay, some, not all. But it is one of those things that if I, you know, go and give a talk, almost, you know, invariably somebody afterwards will come up and say, I've got this family mystery. And, you know, so it's advising them on, okay, so this is how you could do it. This is how you could go about seeing to if you could answer that question. And I'll say, when we announced the second series of DNA Family Secrets, we were absolutely inundated. And loads of people going, look, I don't want to go on the television, but could you help me with this? So there's a massive, massive interest in this. There really is. And there's, you know, we're hopeful that if the series is really popular again, then we'll get to do a third series and so on and so forth and see if we can help more and more people with this.
Amazing. Turi King, thank you so much for joining us this morning on BBC Radio Leicester. I'll be in touch about finding out how I am legitimately a king. Adamant, I'm going to find out that I am at some point.